العلم لك إلا ما علمتنا أنك أنت العليم الحكيم. The new chapter is about رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري وحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. The new chapter about a device called Diode. Look at this animation. What do you see?
Cutting the
circuit. No way. Look at this polarity. Look at this polarity. This is like a resistor. Assuming we have a resistor here. And the voltage polarity is being flipped. And the current is affected by this polarity. The current is somehow related to the polarity. So what is your conclusion? If you know, raise your hand. If you can speak, raise your hand about this. Just see what you see. You're seeing something. What do you see? It's an easy question, yeah. Hussein.
It's like a switch.
Yes. Look at this differential. Can you read it, Hussein?
It is a device that allows the current to flow in a single direction only.
How? How can we achieve this?
By flipping the...
By making the sure if the anode, this is like a resistor, okay? Assuming it's a resistor. It has two terminals. This guy is called the anode, this guy is called the cathode. If the anode is more positive than the cathode, the current will flow. Yeah, if you have a positive here and a negative here, the current will go from where? From positive to negative. So this will allow the current to flow. What about if you have a positive here? Look at this, positive, negative, no current. Okay, so if the anode is more positive than the cathode, the current will flow. In other words, let me make it easy for you. If the voltage here is 5 volt, and the voltage here is 3 volt, 5 and 3, would we have current in this device?
Yes.
Where is the current direction? In this direction. It will allow the current to go. And this is the reason we have this arrow. Look at this arrow. The arrow means the current only can flow in the direction of the arrow. So if you have 5-3, current will flow. And this will act like a closed switch. You will have here like short circuit. What about if I reverse? I will make this 5, and I will make this 3.
Opposite.
Where does the current go?
From 5.
No current.
No current. No current flow. No, current will never go in this direction. Current will never go in this direction. It must go only in the arrow direction. And only if you have high positive than this, the anode is more positive than the cathode. Current will never go from 5 to 3 with this device. Okay? And this is what makes it different. And what is the difference between this and the resistor? Think about the resistor. How they are different?
This
if you have 5-3, current will go this direction. 5-3, current will go this direction. It allows the current in this direction. But this guy, no. It allows the current only from anode to cathode. When? The anode is more positive than the cathode. That's it. This is chapter 9. Chapter 9 in 5 minutes. The remaining is application. The remaining is application. Okay? So what does the diode do, Tony? How does this work, Hamid?
Cancel the flow will be in one direction.
Exactly.
And if the anode is
more positive than the
cathode. More positive than the cathode, then... Yeah,
how does this work? Can you repeat what he said?
Yes.
Okay, go ahead.
The diode is about the current flow in one direction. If anode
is more positive than the cathode. So the current will go in this direction, if this positive and this negative. Okay, or this is higher positive than this. That's it. Current will never go in the other direction. Even if you have positive negative here, current will never go. Yes.
What prevents it from going back?
This is a electronic device. I will cover this briefly, but we have here a semiconductor. You know what a semiconductor?
Yes.
Silicon germanium. It has 4 valence electrons. 4 electrons in the outer band. The interaction between the electronics, we have something called holes and electrons. I think we studied semiconductor in physics. Do you know what are the holes? Electrons? If you haven't, so we have silicon germanium that are doped with some material, and the interaction between the silicon material inside the atoms of the silicon create this behavior. I will cover this later. But this is not what we need. You are mechanical engineering, so we are not going to go deep inside. will go deep outside. Okay? Why is this important? So what is the point? We know we have a device that allows the current to go in one direction. But when the anode is more positive than the cathode. So what? Why we need it? What application we can use this device in? What application? The application, the major application is to convert AC to DC. Convert AC to DC. To convert AC to DC, you must use this guy. Why we need to convert AC to DC? Do you know what is inside this guy's device? Do you know what is here? Do you know how does this work? The charger. Do you know how does it work? It has died inside. What does it do? What does the charger do? Convert AC to DC, right? So we have diodes inside. Did you see this box before? What does it do? Supply the voltage. What is?
Convert AC.
To convert AC to DC. Both of them are doing the same job. Convert AC to DC. In your television, whatever electronic device you have, you must have power supply inside. The electronics work mostly with DC. Okay, we don't use AC that much to excite electronics. So we must have a circuit that converts AC to DC. And this is what the diode does. So the diode is there everywhere. You have diodes in your charger, in your television, in your computer. Diodes is everywhere. We must use diodes everywhere. You know what is this?
Motor.
Mechanical engineering, right? Dynamo, alternator. That's an intelligence alternator, which we call dynamo. What does it do? Take the mechanical energy from the engine, transform it to electric energy to charge your battery. Right? This is how the alternator works. You take the you are driving the car, right? The wheels are moving, so you have mechanical energy. This mechanical energy will rotate the rotor. We have rotor. The rotor will move the coil in magnetic field. How can we generate electricity? By moving a wire in magnetic field. So we need to have some motion, mechanical energy, kinetic energy. The kinetic energy is taken from the engine. So we use the engine rotation to move a wire in magnetic field. When you move the wire, you would produce electricity. What kind of electricity? AC. So this device, so let's look at this. What's the difference? This is a generator. Generator is used to convert mechanical to electric energy. What kind of electric energy? AC-DC. We can have AC-DC from this device. The alternator, the dynamo in your car, that's similar, but there's some difference between generator and alternator. What's the difference?
AC.
This only produces AC. Okay? The dynamo in your car only gives you AC, which is not very useful. Your car battery, what's the voltage of your car battery? The car battery, but let's say, how much voltage we have there?
12
volt DC. This DC volt. So this AC is not useful. So after you use the dynamo, you must have another circuit to convert AC to DC, which is diodes. Okay? So the diodes are there in your car. So this is like a nice animation. So this is the engine. This is the alternator. So the alternator takes the mechanical motion from the engine, right? So this is mechanical here. So we are mechanical. This is the whole system, the engine, and the alternator is here. The alternator is here. The alternator is used to provide electricity to charge the battery. But it cannot work directly. We must have a circuit inside to convert AC to DC. Alternator only gives AC. So we have a circuit inside the alternator that gives DC. This is a bigger circuit. So this is a rotor. This is a dynamo. It has a coil, a big coil. And we have another coil moving in magnetic field. So this big coil produces magnetic field. And we have another wire that's moving in magnetic field. You know how to produce electricity, Ashwin? How can we produce electricity if you have like a magnet, north, south, magnet? And you have a wire, the wire is moving. So you have a magnet, north-south, and the wire is moving. What's going to happen in this wire? Electricity, electric current, this is what we have here. We move the coil in magnetic field, but the coil, the electricity here is not good. You cannot use it with the battery. We must have another guy here. This guy is called the rectifier. So what does the rectifier do? AC to DC. How can we build the rectifier? By diode. So diode is used in your car. Used in your charger, bustle, used everywhere. So we are studying important stuff. We are studying important stuff, which is related to mechanical engineering. So now we connect mechanics with electricity. This video is very nice, very, very nice. I enjoyed it. It explains the whole process, how the alternator works, how can it convert mechanical energy to electric energy. Please watch it. Very, very nice video.
Thank you.
inductor, why it's connecting to a positive path, not a negative path?
To, yeah, it must be to either of them. It could be negative or positive, but we're assuming the current in this direction. And we assume the current going from positive to positive terminal. And usually we connect negative to ground. Usually negative is grounded. But we could flip this. So this is what you have in your charge. If you open this guy, you will see this circuit. This chapter is about studying all these units. We have here, what is this guy? Did you see this before?
Inductor.
It's transformer. What does the transformer do? Transform voltage to another value, high voltage to lower voltage. So the transformer will be used to transform the network electricity. How much voltage you have in the plug? 220 volt EC, right? So big voltage. So the transformer will bring this down to 5 volt EC. Still EC. So the transformer will bring the voltage down from 220 to 5 volt EC. Then we have the diodes. The diodes will do, so the input signal is like this. This is the input signal. Okay? This is what we have in this charger. This is what we have in your power supply computer. This is what we have in your car. Okay, this circuit is everywhere. This circuit mainly transforms EC to DC. So the signal here is EC. After the diodes, here the signal will be, what happened? Yeah, from this point to this point, what happened?
Huh?
Is this EC or DC?
DC, but
still EC. This EC. What's the difference? It's bidirection. Bidirection. The current is moving back and forth. This is unidirection. The current is always positive. Change it, but always positive. Or the voltage is always positive. Okay. Now, so the diodes has been used as rectifier. Rectifier means I can remove either of these positive or negative. And I can choose to remove the positive and keep the negative, or remove the negative and keep the positive. So now I have removed this guy. Now I have unidirectional current, unidirectional voltage. Now we have another circuit. We have a capacitance. What does the capacitance do? It will give you this. So what do you see here?
Almost DC.
Almost DC with some rebates, with some bump. We can smoothen this signal. Yeah, later we can see that the capacitance can be used to make this like a straight line. So the objective of this is to convert EC to this called full wave rectifier, then DC. So step one, two, three. We have three steps. In this chapter, we are going to study, we are going to cover the whole circuit. I know it looks scary, but we will go step by step. Okay? So what does the whole thing do? Convert EC to DC. As I said, the diode will be used to allow the current to go in single direction. So the current here is going from positive to negative. When the anode is more positive than the cathode, the current will never go in the other direction. The current will never go from cathode to anode, regardless of the voltage polarity. Okay? The current only go in this direction. So the chapter 9, we are covering this section. Yani some sections are skipped. I'm not sure, but the book is not doing the right stuff. So I'm going to start with section 9.4. Then I will go back to 9.1. 9.4 is more appealing to be the starting point. So the diode, as you can see, now we are going to introduce ideal diode model. Ideal diode model. What is the relation between ID and VD? Based on what I have said, if VD is positive value, or started to be positive, this higher than this, the current will flow, right? Mm-hmm. If VD is negative, what's the meaning of negative value?
No current.
Just reverse it, right? Yes. So the current is assumed to be from bottom to top, which will never happen. So how can we draw the relation between ID and VD? Based on what I have said, now I need to draw ID versus VD. How does the relation look like? Does this make sense? So ID ampere VD. Does this make sense?
Yes.
Is this what I have said or something different? If the voltage here is negative, negative means like this, negative. What's the meaning of negative? Positive negative. This is the meaning of negative voltage. So the current is assumed to be in this direction, which will never take place, which will never happen. We will never have current in this direction, no matter what. So the current must be zero. What about if the voltage here is not negative? Not negative means anything other than negative. So once it starts to be positive, the current will flow with large value. It doesn't need to go in the positive. Here means it's not negative. Okay? So if the polarity is not negative, the current will flow with large value. This ideal model, ideal. The practical model will be like this. Yeah, instead of having this, it will be like this, which is more practical. You got it? Yeah, the ideal means the voltage, once the voltage VD is not negative, the current will flow with larger direction. This ideal model. The practical model, you will have, it will not be right angle. It will be like this. Okay? This practical model, which will be covered later. Now let's focus on ideal model. So the relation now is that, and how can we write this relation? How can we write some words that explain this? Here, the diode is assumed to be off. Off means the diode is open circuit. Diode is open circuit. Here, the diode, when the current is positive value, the current is on, the current has some value, that's not zero, and we call it forward bias. So reverse bias means the voltage is negative. Forward bias means the voltage is not negative. Here, off, here, on. So the diode will act like a switch. Look at this. This guy is the same as this guy. It's a switch on off. But instead of using your hand, we use voltage. So it's electronic switch. Okay? Yeah, a switch like this switch, you need to use your hand. But here, you don't need to use your hand. You will use the voltage. With controlling the voltage, you can make it on or off. Very easy. So this is, diode is electronic switch. Okay, Shabab? Diode is electronic switch. So what we see here is that if the current is positive, look here in this behavior. Look at this. If the current is positive, this what I see here is that the current is positive and the VD is zero. The diode is on. In this part, which is this? When the voltage is negative, the current is zero. Diode is off. That's it. This line is a shutter line. If you understand this, the remaining part is easy. If you understand this line, the remaining part is easy. So how can I know whether the diode is on or off? On means it allows the current to go. Off means zero current. How can I know it? By looking at ID and VD. You need to look at ID and VD. If the current ID is any positive value, so the diode is on. If the voltage is negative or current is zero, the diode is off. On means short circuit, cross switch. Off means open switch. Very easy. So we need to think about both together, ID and VD. And based on this explanation, we can understand. It's very important. Look at these two lines. The whole chapter is in these two lines. The whole chapter is these two lines. So if you have question, ask me. Because if you don't understand this, you will not understand anything later. Yes.
Why in the first one, VD not bigger than zero?
If it is bigger than zero, actually, this, as I said, this idea, Muhammad, this, the practical, the actual is like this. Once the VD is any positive value, the current will be very large. It doesn't need to go large positive value. Okay? Yeah, this is the actual scenario, which is a practical case. But the ideal assume the current will flow once the voltage is not negative. Once the voltage is not negative, zero. Starting to be positive, the current will flow with large value. So again, look at these two lines. These two lines is the whole diode. The whole story is these two lines. So if you have a question, ask me. Before we move on. Everyone is nice?
Yes.
So can I ask you?
Yes, sir.
And if you don't answer?
Yes.
What's your name? So guys, what's your name? I'm not embarrassing you, Allah. I'm just trying to speak to you. Muhammad? Abdul Mohsin. Can you explain, Abdul Mohsin? I asked you before. Can you explain this behavior, this relation?
It's the voltage going from negative to
You are close, but what we have here, Abdul Mohsin, if the voltage here is not negative means this line. The current will flow with large value, with any value from zero to infinity, any value, based on the circuit. But if the voltage is negative, there's no current flow. The current is zero. Okay, so we need to think carefully about ID and VD. And as I said, the two lines here explain the whole story. Let's again, this is what I said, I repeat it. This area is called forward bias. This area is forward bias. What is the difference between this area and this area? Here, reverse bias. Reverse bias means the voltage, this V is negative, and there's no current. The diode is open. Look at the diode, it's open. Why the diode is open here? Because the voltage here assumed to be negative. V, the voltage less than zero. This voltage has a value and has a polarity. Think carefully. This voltage is always defined by this polarity. Okay?
Yes.
So you need to put in your mind the voltage has a polarity, positive negative. The positive was the anode, negative was the cathode. Then you need to look at the value of V. This is the same. V, if V less than zero, current is zero, which we have seen, which is this relation. If V equal to zero, the current is bigger than zero. Again, this two drawing is the whole summary of the whole shot. If the voltage with this polarity less than zero, which is this behavior, current is zero. If the voltage with this polarity zero, the current bigger than zero. And this guy, this behavior is here, this behavior is here. Yes. Here?
Allow the current to move.
Here?
Yes.
The current only can go in this direction.
Yes.
And based on V, V must be not negative.
Yes.
Okay? V must be, and here, if V is negative, less than zero, no current. Now, if V, the same V with the same polarity, is not negative, equal to zero. Not negative means equal to zero. I is bigger than zero. So you have cross switch. This ideal type, yes. The practical will be later. Yeah. You will see, as I said, yeah, it is not like this. It must have some curvature. But this will be later. Yes. Yes. Question?
Yes, we have like you said.
Mm.
What will
the behavior? If the behavior is shown, so again, yeah, looking at this view, if the voltage with this polarity, if the voltage less than zero, if the less than zero, no current. If the voltage equal to zero, this voltage equal to zero, you will have bigger current, which is this guy. What about if I have this behavior? The actual behavior is this. Zero, zero to go like this. What's going to change in these two equations?
The
V.
What's going to change in this two equation if I have this behavior?
I equal to zero, V equal to zero.
The only change is this. V must be bigger than zero. Bigger than zero. Okay? Instead of V equal to zero, V will be bigger than zero. Bigger than zero means this behavior. Okay? This is the only change. When we move from idle to practical, V must be bigger than zero. I'm just explaining the behavior of the relation. And looking at this relation, you should be able to write these two inequality or these two conditions. So let's try to understand more. So the diode. The diode will be, so this relation is based on this behavior, on this. So we have here, this is V and this I. You must define the voltage polarity and the current direction. This, the relation between V and I is this, as we can see. Look here at this circuit. Look at this circuit. The diode here is in this condition or in this condition?
Forward.
Think about it. This diode is in this condition, on or off? It will be either black or white. No other, no third option. Is it black or white?
We need to see the
value for I and V. Is the voltage here positive or negative?
Positive.
Positive, because you have positive polarity here. What is the current direction? Yeah, look at this circuit. What does the current do? Yeah, this circuit is like this thing, right? Or reverse it? The battery is reversed or the same? See, this is positive, this is ground. So it's clear that the current from the source is moving clockwise. This current will go through or will stop at the diode? Go through. This is how the diode works. So we do have current here. And the voltage is not negative, will never be negative. So what is I and what is V?
V.
So now we are in this region, Shaman. We are here. This diode is here. V equal to? What's I?
I 10 over 1
10 over 1 10 over 1. That's it. So what, how did I understand this? I have a voltage source. it's clear that the current is moving clockwise from the source. The current will go through, no problem, the current will go through. We'll go in the diode. This means the diode is on. On means this behavior, which means V is 0 and I is 10 over 1 K. And the diode here look like what? Yeah, I mean, if I need to replace the diode with something else, what should be?
Short
circuit. Short circuit, just like this one. This is the one. Because the voltage is 0. Now we are here. Now the diode is on or off?
On.
Look at the other diode.
Off.
I only changed the diode. The reverse is the diode. Diode is on or off?
Off.
This diode is working in this region or in this region? Where does the current? Where does the current? Where does the current come from? The current is coming this way, right? Does the current go through? Can the current go through this? It will never go through. Yeah, the voltage source is providing current clockwise, which will never go here. The diode only allows the current in the arrow direction. This means the diode is off, open, open circuit. This, look here, current is zero. Here, current is zero. This means the diode is open, so I equal to
zero.
V equal to
minus.
This open circuit. What does it mean? Take a V, take a V.
Oh,
minus 10. Minus 10. Minus 10.
Minus 10.
Minus
10.
Minus 10. What makes it minus? Negative 10 plus V. So V is positive or negative?
Negative.
What makes it negative? Look, take KVL. What's KVL? Minus 10. This is 10 volt, right?
Oh, 10 volt.
So minus 10 plus V out. Equal to
10.
So V out, V diode. Sorry, V diode is V diode. V diode is
10.
That's it. Again, if you understand this slide, the chapter is, you are okay. Current here, here we have got current 10 milliampere, which is zero, which is this behavior. The other guy, we have no current, zero current and voltage is 10.
Mister.
Yes.
Does the polarity change the effect?
Yes, when you change, if you make this minus 10, so this is a good question.
No, I'm talking about the diode.
What of polarity of what?
The diode.
What do you mean polarity by of the diode?
The positive and the negative.
If you change this,
yes,
you can make it like this. What's the value now?
It will be the same.
Zero. It is the same zero. If you change this, if you want to change this polarity, minus 10. Okay? Yeah, this is up to you. Yeah, he's saying if we change this polarity, what's going to happen? What should be reversed? But that is still off. Yeah, this polarity only to make the voltage positive or negative, but it doesn't change the diode state. That is still off. Here, diode is on. Regardless of whatever you have, current or polarity, diode behavior is on. Here, diode is off. Okay? Thank you, Shabab, for this.